شایسته لیلا ای خوگه خوگه لیلا راش شایسته لیلا.
Assalamu alaikum, Sharag Last. Today I welcome you to our YouTube channel Bitani Sisters and I'm going to teach you how to read and write Pashto. It's very easy to read and write Pashto, but it seems difficult. Why? Because it has certain unique alphabets and letters that are different from Urdu or Quranic Arabic. So that's why we find it difficult. So the focus of my lecture would be on those letters that are different from Urdu or Arabic language. Again, I would like to clarify one thing, that this is not a beginner's video. This video is for those people who have the basic understanding of Quranic or Urdu language. If you want to start Pashto from the basics, then you can see other videos that are available on our channel. There are two dialects in Pashto language. One is Kandahari dialect, the other is Peshawari dialect. Or sometimes Peshawari dialect is known as Yousafzai dialect. But before I go into that detail, I would like to explain the four alphabets that are exactly the same in Pashto language as in Urdu language. The first letter, which you can see, the first alphabet that you can see on your screen is similar to Kaf but with a hook under it. It is actually the Gaf, same Gaf of Urdu with the same sound. The next letter is Re but with a hook under it. It is actually the Re, the same Re of Urdu language, and it makes exactly the same sound. After that, you can see a letter similar to Dal with hook under it. It is actually the Dal, the same Dal of Urdu language. After that, you can see the letter somewhat similar to Te with the hook under it. It is actually Te. It makes exactly the same sound. I guess this does not need further explanation, because if you know Urdu language, this is a very easy concept for you to understand. It's the same alphabets but written differently. After that, you can see a letter or alphabet on your screen that is somewhat similar to the scene but with a dot on top of it and dot under it. This alphabet is actually mean that it can be either read as sheen or khe. Why? Because I told you earlier that there are certain dialects in Pashto language, such as Kandahari and Peshawari dialect, and due to these two dialects, certain words in Pashto are spoken differently. Like, the if we take the example of Pashto word shaista, which means beautiful in Pashto, it can be spoken as shaista or khaista. Shaista in Kandahari dialect and khaista in Peshawari dialect. So for this unique letter alphabet has been created so that written Pashto is not divided. It should be written the same. So this alphabet helps you to read the word alphabet, the word in your own dialect, like shaista, khaista, sha, kh, Pashto, Pakhto. So this alphabet is like, it can be read as sheen or it can be also read as khe. But here there is a very common mistake that people start using this word as a sheen. Like, if they write shpa, they also use the same alphabet to write shpa. Shpa is night in Pashto. But this is wrong. Why? Because shpa is shpa in both dialects, in Kandahari dialect and in Peshawari dialect. So for shpa, you will write it with the normal sheen. You cannot use this alphabet to write shpa, because shpa is shpa in Kandahari dialect and in Peshawari dialect. I hope I have made this point clear. If you still have any confusion, you can write in comments. The next letter which is displayed on your screen is somewhat similar to re, but with a dot on the top of it and dot under it. This alphabet means that it can also be read as gaf or je. Why? Because we have two dialects. So certain words in Pashto language are pronounced with the sound of a gaf, and the same word is pronounced with the sound of je. How? Like gira, jira. Gira, jira is a beard in Pashto. So it can also be pronounced as gira, and it can also be pronounced as jira. Laj, lag, kiji, kiegi. I hope this is enough for you. So we move on to our next letter. It is like a hay, but the only difference is it has three dots on the top of it. It makes the middle sound of the English letter T and S, ts, or in Urdu, seen and che, ts. It's a very difficult sound to make. So few tribes read it as seen and the other tribes read it as che. It's okay. You can do that. Like soak, choke. But the real and the actual sound is soak. But it's difficult to make. So few tribes read it as soak and the other as choke. Salur, chalur, sa, cha, sermon, chairman. There are many words like this. After that, we move on to our next alphabet. It is also like hey, but with hamza on top of it. It makes the middle sound of English letter D and Z, z, or in Urdu, zal and jim, z, like zan. But again, it's a difficult sound to make. So, few tribes read it with zal and the other tribes read it with jim, like zan, jan, raja, raza, jar, zar. But the actual sound is z, z. But it's okay. If you can't make this sound, you can read it with zal or with jim. Now I move to next alphabet. It is like a noon but with a hook under it. It makes the mixed sound of noon and re. Noon and re how? N, n, n. There are certain words in Pashto in which we use this sound, like rana. Rana is light. Rana, atan, rana, atan. So this alphabet, it makes the mixed sound of noon and re. I hope you will like my lecture, and if you have any questions, if you have any queries, you can put it in our comments and we will reply it back to you. And I hope you enjoyed watching this video and I hope you will learn something from it. Thank you. Keep watching our videos. Khuda hai paman.